Ladies and gentlemen, your United States Navy Flight Demonstration Squadron takes pleasure in performing for you this, our 45th flight demonstration of the 2014 season. I'm Lieutenant Ryan Chamberlain, narrator for the Blue Angels. Demonstrating to the American public the precision techniques of naval aviation, hoping to inspire a culture of excellence and service to country. The maneuvers you will see demonstrated here this afternoon are coordinated tactical techniques developed by Navy and Marine Corps pilots in both peacetime training and actual combat. These maneuvers are neither stunts nor daring feats, but are refinements of basic techniques taught to every prospective naval aviator. Here at Naval Air Station Oceana, we will demonstrate these maneuvers at very low altitudes in traditional Blue Angel formation so that you may see and take pride in the precise fashion in which your Navy and Marine pilots are trained to fly. Now, direct your attention to the ramp to your right and observe the military manner in which the six demonstration pilots approach their aircraft and are saluted by their crew chiefs. Ladies and gentlemen, flying Blue Angel number one, the commanding officer and flight leader of the Blue Angels from Clinton Township, Michigan, Captain Tom Frosch. Flying Blue Angel number two, the right winger from Fort Mitchell, Kentucky, Lieutenant Commander John Hilt. Flying Blue Angel number three, the left winger from Hummelstown, Pennsylvania, Lieutenant Commander Nate Barton. Flying Blue Angel number four, the slot pilot and the Marine Corps representative in the Delta formation from Hemet, California, Major Brandon Cordill. Flying Blue Angel number five, the lead solo from Birmingham, Alabama, Lieutenant Commander Dave Tickle. Flying Blue Angel number six, the opposing solo from Charleroi, Pennsylvania, Lieutenant Mark Tendro. Found in all Navy and Marine Corps units. The Blue Angels also take a great deal of pride in personifying Navy and Marine Corps values of honor, courage, and commitment.
Courage and commitment. Where's that guy?
The Navy's Flight Demonstration Squadron, the Blue Angels, is the oldest performing U.S. military aviation demonstration team. Since 1946, the Blue Angels have brought naval aviation to men and women of all ages across America. We were first based at Naval Air Station Jacksonville, Florida, flying F-6F Hellcats, and we continued flying Grumman Corporation aircraft for 22 years, transitioning in late 1946 to the more powerful and faster F-8F Bearcat. In 1950, we transitioned a jet aircraft with the straight-wing F-9F2 Panther, the predecessor of the swept-wing F-9F8 Cougar, which we received in 1955. In 1957, the Blue Angels became equipped with high-performance aircraft with the arrival of the supersonic F-11 F-Tiger. In 1969, we received the McDonnell Douglas F-4 Phantom and flew this supersonic jet until 1974, when we transitioned to the A-4 Skyhawk. We are now in our 28th year of flying the highly sophisticated Boeing FA-18 Hornet.
Warning you.
The pilots and crew chiefs will now start the general electric engines that power these FA-18s. The noise level will soon become too high for you to hear a description of the checks they will be performing. However, please note that each aircraft was carefully inspected by expert Blue Angels maintenance personnel prior to this afternoon's aerial demonstration. The Blue Angels fly the Boeing FA-18 Hornet, a multi-mission strike fighter, versions of which have been operational throughout the fleet since 1983. Clears the flight line, our two solo pilots will begin their takeoff maneuvers. A dynamic demonstration of the thrust produced by these General Electric engines, Lieutenant Commander Tickle will roll Blue Angel number 5 360 degrees immediately after takeoff. As he clears the flight line, Lieutenant Tendril and Blue Angel number 6 will execute a very precise low transition and exit the flight line in the inverted position. Now with the Diamond establishing the fingertip formation. They'll accelerate their engines to 85% power, carefully check their engine instruments, and respond to Captain Frosch with a thumbs up indicating they are ready to go. With a thumbs up from each of his wingmen, Captain Frosch will call for the selection of afterburner, and the Blue Angel Diamond will be rolling. Accelerating to 150 miles per hour, he will pull back on the stick, flying the formation into the air. Immediately after liftoff, Major Cordill will call for the landing gear and flaps to come up, and they'll commence the Diamond Burner go. Low transition on takeoff. Now, to the left, Captain Frosch calls, smoke on! Off brakes, now! Burners ready, now! And the Blue Angel Diamond is rolling. As they pass before you, you will notice the smoke is not visible while the engines are in afterburner. execute a very precise low transition as he accelerates his aircraft to 300 miles per hour. He will then roll his aircraft 180 degrees and exit the flight line in the inverted position.
Thank you.
sometimes pitching deck of an aircraft carrier at sea, slow-speed flight is just as important as high-speed flight. In order to demonstrate the dirty, slow-speed handling characteristics of these Boeing F-118s, Captain Frost has called for the extension of the landing gear and tail hooks by the four Diamond pilots, while Lieutenant Cutter with Blue Angel number 6 turns his smoke on and attempts to overtake them at center point at airspeeds approaching 600 miles per hour. From the left, the dirty, clean flat pass.
Show me the Hornets.